be strict with yourself. Don't entertain the mind. You're not a container for concepts. There's nothing to destroy. Just go deeper. Empty, 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 empty. There's no need to go into form. Don't take any shape. Stay as awareness only. Deeper still. The sense of the person is sustained by habit. All this is visible to you. You are its witness, but not an involved witness. Naturally detached. All things arise and appear within you and pass on like clouds floating in infinite space. You are none of this. Though it arises within you, stay only as the awareness. You are neither a person, nor are you personal. In the place of the what is, There are no stories. No facets. Neither is there time. It is not something that you are doing. You're only to recognize this. It in itself is effortless. Even the intention to reach it is a thought appearing in it. You are already here. In truth, the seeker is not a reality. It is a mode of consciousness, necessary for a time, until now, when the seeker and the seeking becomes perceivable. Beyond. But when will this be? While we are identified with the position of a seeker, the seeking will feel real and necessary, of course. But something watches the seeker and the seeking. Be there. In this place, there is no struggle. Only you may confirm. Why to be empty? It is our natural state. The mind doubts, how will I manage if I'm empty? Let the self manage the mind, if there is such a thing. You are capable of receiving this guidance, this pointing. Honor yourself. More dreaming is not needed. Business. What season? Where is Sunday or Monday in the business? And yet, it is complete. Sometimes from the mind, the feeling comes, I can't do it, I cannot do it, I cannot get it. But look, these are just thoughts and feelings, observable. Be in the place of the weakness. This weakness in consciousness does not have past nor future. It is beyond need. Who are you? Are you an object appearing in front of the lens of perception or behind? sense of person needs a context and a story. But truth has no story. Why are you afraid? It is the mind and the person that clings, not the self. If the mind were to cling to the self, it would vanish. Your greatest joy appearing as your greatest fear. Can it be that in each body, in each form, the pure self, the isness, appears differently? Is it personal? And who will know this? Who will verify this but the self itself? I don't accept or believe any stories. All is false, dreamed, momentary, unreliable, inconsistent. How much time is wasted? An exhausting indulgence. Stay on the mountaintop of your own being. It's nothing personal. Leave waiting aside now. Leave your imaginings aside. Identity. Simply leave everything aside. There's no need to destroy. Leave it. It's enough. Try and see. Leave everything that you perceive. Don't combine yourself with anything that you perceive. Remain as what remains. When it becomes clear for you that this knowledge, this understanding, you do not have, you are, then you can move about in this world uncontaminatable. Re-enter your own source. Then you will know what the world is. Strange that being empty of all things, don't be a collector of impressions. How strange that in being empty of all things, you're so delightfully complete, unbound, overflowing with love. Peace. This is not a promise I am making. It is a call to verify this through direct experience. Are you waiting to be? Mind is waiting. Person is waiting. Is that the same as you? Don't give yourself the freedom to spend another day in ignorance. Don't believe in your mind. He's not your friend. Not yet. Come inside alone. Take nothing with you. And you will become the evidence of the truth. Have this much courage. Leave everything for a moment to be entirely empty, alone, beyond even the concept of aloneness. Who is looking out from behind those eyes? Is it person or presence? Drink deep. Follow this pointing. Are you not filled with the Holy Spirit? With whom will you make an appointment? Are you on the waiting list for freedom? in the subtlety of your own being, you will recognize the clues that are dropped by the Absolute. For me, there is no tomorrow, nor yesterdays. I'm only now. But not the now of time. The timeless now. Don't offer this to your mind. It will only distort and abuse. Look without, look outside, and a million things come for you to see. Look within. What are you finding? Yet the pure self is beyond withinness or withoutness. To whom do I speak? Are you still carrying your presence? Still sponsoring? Waiting. Observe. Who or what will be waiting? What observes even waiting? who is without attachment. Is that waiting? As who did you enter this hall? As who will you leave? I am here with you, not to tell you more stories, but to reveal who you are. Storybook. Be a living book. and better still. Be the formless self. Or if you like, the self beyond form. What is wrong with form? Nothing. Just you are beyond that. Forms come and go. The self does not come or go. When will you be able to confirm this for yourself? Is today not good? Is another day, another moment, more auspicious than this one?